penalty will be 2,000 rupees, paying by cash card UPI.
Cash, okay.
Shakti?
You're paying by cash, right?
Cash.
So we have a interactive session with the animals starting right now at 11:15. Would you like to join that or the next, which will be starting
what's
at
the time
11:45?
We'll go by 9:45.
Okay.
Cool. So your group number is 5 and 11:45 we will start. Okay. So till that time, you just have to go straight. Next 30 meters, left hand side, there's a big hut. That's a common area. Just be there. Tables and chairs are there. Guys will come and take it from you.
Enter your. Yes.
Alala.
Bengal College.
Here at Prani, we have more than 700 rescued animals. So we'll have to keep in mind they've had a rough past. So we'll have to be very gentle and we'll have to handle them with care. Okay? And here we have Isha and Gautam will be joining us in a little bit. We're going to take care of this part. We have four different sections. This is the first section. Here it's called the rodent area because, like the name says, we have a lot of rodents here. And in each section, there'll be different guides who'll take you around the tour. So now, the rodents are going to be very small, okay? So I don't want them to fall down or slip off your hand and drop them. So I want you all to sit down so that even if you drop them, they will not get hurt. So you can please sit down. Okay, have you guys seen this little fellow before? Any idea? Any guesses? No, I'll tell you all the difference. It's not a rat and not a mouse because these guys have fur even on their tail. Rats and mouse will not have fur on their tail. So any guesses?
Hamsters,
no? So this is called a gerbil. J-E-R-B-I-L-S. Gerbils, this is a Mongolian gerbil. And in the deserts of Mongolia, it gets very hot during the day. And during the night, it gets very cold. When it gets very cold, they wrap this furry tail on their ears and face, which keeps them warm. And that's how they go to sleep. Okay? Now, since these rodents are very small, you guys have to keep your palm flat and don't cuff or don't cover. Okay? Everybody ready? Okay, we'll start. So this is a Scillian hamster, and the Scillian hamster is the largest breed of hamsters in the world. And a very cool thing about the hamsters are they have cheek pouches like monkeys. So what they can do is they can store food up to half their body weight in their cheek pouches. Okay? Now, again, since the hamster is small, keep your hands flat. Isha and Gautam will bring the animal to y'all. When the rodent is born, they are born without any fur. It's just the skin which is pink in color, so they're called pinkies. After 12 days, they start getting a little bit of fur, so they're called fuzzies. After 18 days, they start moving and hopping, so they're called hoppers. Then comes the subadult stage and then adult stage. So for the next one I'm going to bring, he's born at a subadult stage. Meaning they're born with completely developed ears, eyes, nose and mouth. After a few minutes of birth, they can eat solid food as well. Now, can you guess what this animal is? Very good. This is a guinea pig.
That's nice.
Next, he is very sensitive and he is very delicate. So we will not give it to you all. We will hold it. You can come close and we'll touch the animal, okay? But I want you to guess what it is. Snake.
No, I wish.
Snake.
Hedgehog, very good. So this is an African pygmy hedgehog. Pygmy means small. They will not grow bigger than this. Can you tell me how? What is their main defense mechanism? Correct. They turn into a ball. Okay. Now I want you guys, pay attention to me for a second. When you are touching or patting the animal, always go from the head to the tail. If you go the other way around, you are going to get hurt. Okay? So one by one, you can come close. One by one, please don't, two of you don't put your hands together. We'll start off with the kids first and then the adults, okay? Once you are done, follow me.
ಮುಳ್ಳ ಅದು ಮುಳ್ಳ ಇದು
ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಫುಲ್ ಮುಳ್ಳು ಇರುತ್ತೆ
ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಕಿನ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಅಲರ್ಜಿ ಇಲ್ಲ
ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಸ್ಲೋ
ಎಸ್ ಸೌತ್ ಅಮೇರಿಕಾ ಸೊ Don't get scared, you're not in class. You can give me whatever answer comes to your mind, okay? Doesn't have to be right. This is Ivan. Ivan's the oldest iguana. He's about 10 years old here. And we rescued him from a pet store in Chennai. Ivan is a victim of the pet industry where they have hundreds or 200 animals put in one small cage. So you can actually see he's missing three claws in front. He's missing a little bit of his tail. He's injured his jaw and he has plenty more injuries. And Ivan is an adult green iguana. The adult iguanas can grow up to 6 feet. And a very interesting and cool fact about the iguanas are the herbivores. They won't even, they can't digest an ant. And also, there's a debate which says the iguanas have a third eye. Okay, but that's actually still, being researched on. This is the third eye is placed on his forehead. That is actually a sensory organ which helps him detect light and shadow. So they're arboreal creatures, meaning they spend most of their lifetime on treetops. Okay, this sensory organ actually helps him see light and shadow. So his natural predators are hawks, eagles and etc. Birds of prey. When they come in to attack these guys, they can sense it and they'll run away to safety. Alright, and the main mode of defense is their tail. The tail is made of muscle, it's pure muscle, and they use it like a whip. If he whips my arm, it's strong enough to dislocate my arm. So when you're coming close to pat him, please don't touch his tail, don't touch his head and face. These two bulbs you see here is called the subtympanic shield. And this one here is called the dewlap. That the two of the dewlap and the subtympanic shield is used to attract the females and to show dominance. So now, y'all can come close. One by one, we'll start off with the kids. The kids can touch his tummy. Okay, touch the body, not the head and the tail. Yeah, who wants to go first? Yeah. Come on. Okay, one second. I'll just let him calm down. Okay, once y'all are done, step back and give others a chance.
You know, it takes a lot of time and people are already waiting.
Okay, so this is our second section, and here we have the two large animals of a farm. So these are ponies, and on the other side we see the horse. So that's a race horse. Her name is Maya. So Maya was rescued from Pune stud farm. So you all see the nail-like thing in their leg? So that is called as a hoof. She has a right deformed hoof. So her problem is she can't run faster for longer duration. So that's why the racecourse people plan to mercy kill her. So in racecourse, what happens is, if a horse doesn't meet up their requirement, they mercy kill them because it's very expensive to maintain a horse. So what do you think ponies are? No, they're not the baby horses. They are the shorter breed of horses. So baby horses are called as foals. And you all see their eyeballs. They have the largest eyeball than any other land mammal, even that of an elephant. So it can cover a vision up to 290 degrees, except their head and the back, because these two are the blind spots for them. So if we touch them there, either they bite or they kick. Okay, how many of you say it's a turtle? So this is not a tortoise nor a turtle. They are called as terrapins, or their common name is red eared sliders. So if I make any sudden movement inside their pond, they all just slide inside the water. That's why they are called as sliders. Okay. So what we see, all the small coin sized turtles in aquarium shop, they are all not turtles, they are actually terrapins. And you can all touch them, but please don't tap or knock on the shell, and don't approach him from the front. But please touch him like this.
What is the lifespan for this?
40 years, sir.
40 years.
Actually the shield
is the bone structure and the bone.
So now we'll all be walking in, they're all very friendly. You can touch any of them. But please don't carry the younger ones or try to feed them.
I'm already
asking. Observe their pupils.
So
in what shape are they?
You
can look at this one.
Like a kidney bean.
Just in a rectangular shape. Just observe that. So in any case, why do they have rectangular pupils? Sir, please no carrying the younger ones. Sir, please no carrying. So they have a wider vision. So they can cover a vision up to 320 degrees, which is more than a horse. So they are all browsers. They eat the fuzzy leaves, which are as high. So while they are having their food, they also need to have a watch on their predator. That's why they all would be having rectangular pupils. And goats were the first animals to be tamed by humans. And what we see them as herd. The formation of herd was actually done before 9,000 years ago.
I'll just guess it, which bird is this? Anyone? It's not a guinea fowl. What is that? Which bird is that? Anyone know? That's not a bulldog. Okay, all these are called silver pheasants. They're called pheasants. So they are belong to the peacock family also. These are like, the one is a white one, that's a male one, and the browner was in a female one. So like male, they'll be having more colors on their body. So to attract the female and show the dominance. But the females, they have their single color on their body because they need to camouflage themselves, so they'll be having a single color. So when they are like an aggressive and they are like happy, or then it should show the like dominance, or like you attract the female, they'll be open their wings and they're gonna make very good noises also. And these guys, they'll be like native to China. So they came only for the breeding purpose, much to the India. So again, we'll be not touching these guys. Once you're done seeing them, you can all just occupy the space. There is a slab. So I'll get the rabbit out. You can just gently touch one. Are you sure it's a rabbit? Hey. Okay, what's the difference between a rabbit and a hare?
Hare are bigger.
Okay, hare are bigger. Then, the first. No. Okay, okay, so the rabbits are the exotic animals and the hares are wild animals. So we can't keep any hares in captivity, that's illegal to keep them. So these are exotic ones, they are native to European. So okay, how do you hold the rabbits now? Is the right way to hold?
No.
Yes. So while you need to support all the four legs, so while
that's
not a comfortable zone for them also, because the whole body will be controlled with the ears. Once you begin them, you're gonna move to the depth also. So please don't hold with the ears. So I'm gonna come near to you. You can just sit on there. I'll place it on your lap. You can just gently touch it.
Okay.
Main chasta hai woh
Indian rabbits are called hare.
Okay.
Hare. So we won't have any rabbits in India. So the, all these are exotic animals.
Nice,
Softly.
Little
tortoise. They are tortoise. They call sulcata tortoise. The sulcata, they are native to Africa. So these guys will survive for the 150 years. So they'll grow up to this parboat sheep size. Okay, you wanna try to touch? Just touch only on the shell. He's just moving around. And please don't try to touch near the faces, okay? And please don't tap, they can also sense what you're doing. But these are ponies. The first one is Bob. He was rescued from like near the land. But someone took them near Banagata. But he doesn't stay for a very long time from near Banagata. He just came back from the Banagata to Prani, and the whole he just walked from there here. He landed with the Prani and he chose the Prani. He's right here. He's not okay with any touchings and all. And here we have Kadir. You saw ponies behind in the front. Isha. And Isha's second son is right here now. The first son is in the grazing. This is the second son. Once you are done,
like a dance.
Okay, so right here we have Krishnagiri dwarf donkey. A dwarf, that's a short, and this is a maximum size they can use. So okay, can you all just observe, the donkeys have very longer ears compared to the horse and the ponies. Why? Donkeys were like native to like in desert countries more. So they need to cool their body temperature. So the like whole body circulation done. In the end, they'll come to the ears. So they're gonna cool their body temperature, so they'll be having a like very longer ears. And they also belong to the zebras family. How do you touch any hoofed animals now?
Neck.
Yeah. So you can touch only on the neck part. You can't touch the head or the back. So I'll give some grasses. You can all stay here. You can just feed for the donkey. Yeah.
Sheep have a thick coat of fur and all goats have a thin coat of fur. After removing the fur, it can wool. Yes. And all sheep are grazers. Grazers means they eat like ground level grass. All cows, sheep, buffalo, all are grazers. And all goats are browsers. Browsers means they eat like grass from the ground level. They eat like branches, trees. Okay. And these are Bunnurujis. They are native from Mandya.
इधर लाला
इलो गेट
टकर नंबर है इतना सारा
तो नहीं है ना बेटा इधर
बनर कुरी बनर कुरी बोलो वो मटे इधर जीजी
टच कर
रहा हूँ ए वर्षो ये वर्षो वर्षो हाले संता कौन है
Color, okay. The feather is different. It's like
okay. I'll tell. Okay. Ostrich is native from Africa, and emu is native from Australia.
Okay.
Yes. And ostrich can grow up to 9 feet, and emu can grow up to 5 up to 6 feet. The main difference, you can observe the emu toes. Emu have 3 toes. Ostrich have only 2 toes. Yes. Can emu fly? Why?
Their feathers are not that.
Their body is too heavy. Yes, the body will be heavy, that's why they can't fly. They can run up to 40 km per hour. And ostrich can run up to 60 km per hour. Yes,
go ahead. Go ahead. Go
ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go
ahead.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಮುಟ್ಟಿದ್ಯ ಏನು ಆಗಲ್ಲ ವಾಸನೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ
ಇವರಿಗೆ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ನೋವ್ ಇರೋ ಲಾಟ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಸಿಟ್ ಆನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಶೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಟಚ್ ಎನಿ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಮೈ
Please sit on the slab, sir.
Guys, silence, please.
Please come over there.
Come, please stand on the corner. Please stand on the corner.
Very good. Puyo.
Please
One more time.
Now you should not make a noise, okay? When you are making a noise, they won't speak a lot.
Hello.
You all see that?
Yeah.
So these guys, they'll spit up to 6 to 7 feet in the captivity. In the wild, they can easily spit for the 10 feet high. That's like snake fish. Naked fish. They will grow very big. And they are native to Australia and also found in India. In Sundarban forest, in only the mangrove zoo. Yeah, he's hiding. And they're gonna grow up to a huddle's palm size. Still small babies, we are holding in the tweezer. When they grown up, we're gonna give branches on that. So they're gonna like lead the beetles. So when they're moving the beetles, they're gonna try to spit the water. The post will of spitting the water, the worms will fell down, then they eat. Yeah?
Touch his body. Okay, so one by one I can come close. Don't put 2-3 hands on him, he will not like it.
Danger is it?
Danger.
Adu nam manne idu correct idu padu maga hoyte idu chetadra
am urugana hoyte idu
antara
adu
ha.
ಅದೇನು ಸರ್ ನಂತರ